Good afternoon and welcome back to Nasdaq Trade Talks. I'm your host, Jill Malandrino, global markets reporter at Nasdaq. Joining me at MarketSite, we have Bob Yauger, who's a senior energy analyst over at Mizuho Americas. It's great to have you back with me at MarketSite as always, and it looks as if the oil bulls are in retreat since we last spoke.
Yes, they certainly are. There's a lot of good reasons for it. First of all, it's risk off as far as all asset groups are basically concerned. So obviously the equity markets have been lower too. Commodity markets have tumbled with them, but also commodity markets, energy in particular, look towards the equity markets as a demand indicator very often. So the assumption is to a certain degree, if corporate America is not doing well, well, demand is probably not going to be very good either. So the commodity tends to slide with it to a certain degree. And then recently, a recent development has been the Iran sanctions situation.
Right.
It looked like there was going to be a zero tolerance type situation with the Trump administration. First, they started to leak that they are maybe open to the idea of a couple waivers, and then that turned into two on Friday, and today it turned into eight, and the market has taken some significant lumps as a result of that. Also, OPEC production has been ramped up pretty good, too, and that has also put the pressure on WTI. And finally, the EIA, domestic production here, and storage in the United States has been through the roof. So we've really added a lot of barrels to storage here the last couple weeks. It's a seasonal phenomenon. You slow down refineries this time of the year to refurbish them. It's near the heating demand or gasoline demand. It's a good time of the year to do it, but storage is going up accordingly.
Right. So basically they were expecting that Iran supply crunch. OPEC turned on the spigots, as did we, and now we have all this oversupply that we have to contend with. Now, have forecasters been tempering their Q4 and 2019 outlook?
They have to a certain degree now because it doesn't seem that the bid is in the market. Demand is quite what they were expecting. I do see some people still holding on to the $85 target, things along these lines, and I think that's possible. A lot of it depends on how cold winter is, things along these lines. Your geopolitical situation could go postal at any given moment.
Right.
Everybody knows that, and we're accustomed to that. But if all things being equal, I find it hard to believe that we will rally above and beyond. We may get to where the highs were, but a couple weeks ago, for example, there was a lot of activity in the $100 calls for multiple months in the futures markets, options on futures markets. And you're not seeing that anymore.
Right.
People have backed away from the $100 calls. In other words, they're not looking to really high levels to participate anymore. It's that activity has definitely pulled back.
So you're seeing like hedge funds and money managers and so forth actually liquidating positions and not showing interest in those higher level calls?
They're not showing interest in those higher level calls. The CFTC spec position and also the ICE Brent position, it's a way of measuring the spec, the hedge fund participation in the commodity space, and it's been pulling back really strong here in the last couple of weeks. And I can only imagine what happened this week, especially yesterday. And you only go to as far as Tuesday. The reporting period ends on Tuesday, so you won't see yesterday, but we are already down percentage points on Tuesday, and that would account for the second half of last week too, so that was a slide also. It's going to be a big number this week. It has slid so much at this point that for the first time I can remember in recent history, the natural gas spec position is larger than the crude oil spec position.
Oh, that's interesting. So when you look at crude levels right now, what range do you think is appropriate based on the fundamental environment and what you're seeing from a technical perspective?
Well, what's going to happen now, in my opinion, is the refiners here in the United States are going to come out of turnaround season. They've pulled back on refining capacity, the rate that our refineries can run at, by like 10-12%. That's going to come back online. They need to make heating oil for winter. They make gasoline also in the process. You can't make one without the other. So they're going to come back. We're going to start to see storage draws here in the United States. That's going to start to help. I have a feeling that we're pretty close to a bottom here. The market's definitely oversold. There's certain indicators that tell you if it's overbought or oversold. It's oversold right now. I have a feeling we're getting close to a bottom. We'll rally back $5 at least, I would tend to believe. I think the market's going to be in this 67.5 to 75 area, a little bit higher than this because of the refineries coming back. And I think that we'll probably find there'll be some news that will support a little bit higher prices. Eventually, the Iranian situation is going to start to bite no matter what the number is. So these people that are getting waivers, they still have to continue to pull back on production. We're only giving them waivers because they've already made some cuts.
So that's really the biggest outlier in the oil markets right now is what's going to happen
with the Iran situation.
Iran.
It is. Of course, It's oil.
Anything's possible, right?
Anything's
of course.
Possible.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us at MarketSite. And thank you for joining me. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at NASDAQ.